Hi, I am Rena Garg, your BLCC Femina Miss India Tamil Nadu 2020. Actually, no, it did come as a surprise to me, but there is a fun fact that I would like to share with all of you, that when I was a baby and my parents could not decide on a baby name, so my father picked up my name from one of the Miss India contestants, contestant number 22, back in the year when I was born. So now that I am here today, my father tells me that it's all coming back to me so many years later. I think being here at Miss India, I'm looking forward to build lasting relationships with the people in the organization and with my co-contestants, to learn more about myself and about the world, and to most importantly be so aware that I can open up meaningful conversations with people. So I was fairly confident of making it to the top 5 of my state, but the interview was a little nerve-wracking, because the women who were competing alongside me were such beautiful, strong women, women of substance. So I was bound to be nervous, but I'm really happy and really grateful that I was chosen to represent the state of Tamil Nadu. Well, like we all know that the Miss India pageant is being conducted virtually and for the first time. So I was really excited to learn about my co-contestants through the virtual medium, understand their journeys, what they bring with themselves and their states, and of course the sponsor hampers. I mean, who isn't excited about free gifts? Tamil Nadu is a state that is known for its rich cultural heritage, language, arts and literature. But what a lot of people don't know is that it is also the state with one of the highest female employability ratios. That is, there are significantly more women than men who are employed and independent. Tamil people are really close to nature and they try to incorporate nature in all of their practices and traditions. So one of my favorite Tamil traditions is the giving of kurkumkum, turmeric, betel leaves and betel nuts when they invite any of their guests home. I think it's very beautiful and it also shows how they value and nurture nature. My top 3 favorite Tamil dishes are pongal, puliyodarai and sundal. And I think all of you should definitely go and check them out. My favorite national holiday that the Tamilians celebrate with great enthusiasm is of course Pongal, because Pongal is the harvest festival where they worship the sun god and the nature, and it's just beautiful how everyone comes together to celebrate this festival. I graduated in 2020 during the pandemic with a bachelor's in technology degree, and currently I'm working as a software engineer. While in college, I was associated with Google's Women Tech Makers program as an ambassador, where I was helping young girls build a better future through technology. A cause that is very close to my heart is women restricting themselves to societal confines. I want them to have multiple dimensions and facets to their personality and own it with confidence. I was a pretty active kid in school and I used to enjoy playing football and volleyball in run relay races. I'm also a trained Kathak dancer and I love to practice yoga in my free time. Not very long ago, I was invited on a sponsored trip to Google I/O to meet Mr. Sundar Pichai as a part of the Women Tech Makers Ambassador program, which I'm very proud of. Apart from this, I have been a scholar and an academically excellent student all throughout my school life. I love listening to podcasts. Recently, I have been tuning into the Michelle Obama podcast. You should also check it out. Apart from this, I love to cook and dance. My proudest personal achievement so far has been representing Tamil Nadu at Miss India 2020. Because when I won the title, I could see my parents and my family come together and show so much love and support for me that it just made me feel so humbled and grateful as a person. I am really proud to be here. A moment or an incident that has changed my life would be the recent pandemic, because it taught me to value my interpersonal relationships above everything, to be grateful for what I have than to ask for more, and to see everything with a silver lining.